Nope.
Yeah. Who got that good D? I got that good D.
For the cheapest, fastest, most reliable muck coins in the market, check out my coin sponsors at AOEAH.com and use discount code MONEY for 3% off. Link in the description below. Welcome back, Money Team. This is Mad Money Shot. Snippet of the Madden cheese as always. Got a defense video for you guys today. Today I'm going to be going over what I think is without doubt the best run defense in Madden 22 right now. I'm going to show you guys a run defense glitch that I put out in a previous video, but I'm also going to go over a defensive play that in my opinion is one of the best base defenses for run or pass. The formation itself is the 3-4 odd, and the play that I'm going to show you guys today, I mean, there's a couple plays. I put out a full scheme from this formation not too long ago, so I'll have a link in the description if you guys want to see that. If you guys want to see a full breakdown of this defense, you know, this play I'm going to show you guys, plus some blitzes and all that stuff in a full scheme, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section. I'll put that out at a later date. Now the play I'm going to show today is the cover four drop show two. This has been an overpowered defense for a very long time, so let's go and let's pick that. On the offensive side, I'm just going to pick a random run play. Now as always, this video is brought to you by my coin sponsors at AOEH.com. if you guys want to get your mutt team up like mine, make sure to check them out. Links in the description below, and use discount code money to get 3% off what's always guaranteed to the cheapest coins on the market. Now as far as this play goes, I picked random run play. I'm not really going to do too much. I can run, number one, I don't really have to do anything. Cover four is a superior run defense. These safeties just naturally fill the run lanes, and I'll go ahead and I'll let it run without any adjustments. I brought him down to the box a little bit, but I'll just show you guys without any adjustments what these safeties typically do. Now he made some moves there, got more yards than he will when I put in my setup, but just so you guys know, whether you're playing this on current gen or next gen, cover four is just always one of the best run defenses, and you can see the amount of coverage we get. But like I said, if you don't guess pass in a cover four, typically these safeties will walk down and fill run lanes. You can see he's the first one there to make a play, even though he kind of over pursued a little bit. He meets him 2 yards past the line of scrimmage. So just as it's set up, the safeties make this defense an elite run defense. So without a doubt, just know that if you're on current gen, because some of the tricks I'm going to show you today only work on next gen. Now as far as the setup goes, there's quite a few steps. First thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Y triangle, then I'm going to baseline, then I'm going to show blitz. Y triangle again, and then show blitz. That's Y triangle right on the left stick, then Y triangle left on the left stick. So that's basically going to bring up my alignment like this. The next step I'm going to do is I'm going to basically pinch my entire defense, which is going to be right bumper R1, then down on the left stick. The reason I'm doing that, I don't know why, but since I've been pinching my defense, it's just been kicking this run game or this run defense up an entire notch. I do this out of a lot of blitzes too. I just find that for whatever reason, I mean, number one, there's no lanes, but number two, you can see we still have outside containment most of the time, and this just really kicks the run game up a notch. Then the last step I'm going to do is I'm going to hit Y triangle one more time, and I'm going to go underneath for hard flats, and this is basically going to be my look. This is an absolute shutdown run defense. It's going to give you a lot of really good pass coverage as well, and this is pretty much how I can do it. Now if I want to, I want to back these cornerbacks off. Sometimes that's a good move if you have time for that, but ultimately you don't want them necessarily in a position where if your opponent does decide to pass, that's going to be one of the weaknesses. They could run streaks if they're fast enough right past those cornerbacks. But as far as the run defense goes and everything else, you know, pass defense over the middle, everything's pretty much going to be shut down. Now the last step, I mean, I can run this just like this, and I'm going to do that, but the last step, if you're on next gen consoles, is you can actually run commit. You can actually go RBR1, which is a trick I showed in a video a couple days ago. You can run commit, and you're going to see how you have pretty much no penalty at all when it comes to pass committing, and the reason is because there's only 3 down linemen blitzing. Now, I know a lot of people think that this got patched in a recent patch. It did not. You'll see right here that, you know, these guys are going to run commit, but take my word for it. If it was a pass play, they would not run commit, unless you're on current gen consoles. Current gen does not have that run commit trick, but like I said, every other setup I show you, I'm only going to do this once, and then the rest of the time here, I'm going to do it as normal. But you can see right here, we just get an amazing amount of run defense right through the middle there. If you guys didn't catch that video with the run commit glitch that I'm talking about, I'll show you one time how it works. So we're going to go ahead, we're going to pick cover four again. This time, we're going to purposely pick a pass play. We're just going to pick the double pump and go. So I'm going to go ahead and do the exact same setup. Like I said, I'm going to run commit, and I'm also going to do the hard flats. So, like I said, we're ranking it here. I'm gonna hit the bumper down on the thing. You can see it right there on the screen, and you're gonna see how this is gonna have, you know, it's not run committing, which is, like I said, it's a glitch. It's a glitch based off the fact that you don't have, he's just throwing the ball away. But it's based on the fact that you have three down linemen pass rushing. That is the reason that this works. So if you were to make a mistake, like say you have a fourth guy, okay, we do the exact same thing, although I did mess it up there a little bit, but it doesn't really matter because it's gonna go off the wall. So we're run committing this time. Now that we have a fourth guy going in, watch what happens. Not only that, but fourth guy, but also a linebacker. You're gonna see how all these guys run commit again. So like I said, it's real simple. You just need to have three down linemen. There is an alternative. If you're on current gen, there is another way to do this. I'll go ahead and I'll put it back on random run. If you're on current gen and you want the same benefits, I would just say blitz all. This is gonna give you obviously less pass coverage, but you know, this is something that you can do. If you want the same similar effect when it comes to run committing, I mean, you're getting that with the linebackers. So that's something that I actually do quite a bit in some of my blitzes anyway. So I don't really find that it's a huge disadvantage, but you can see if I just do it like this, if you're on current gen, this is probably the best way to do it. And I still can drop back in coverage with Roberts. So like I said, this is something that you're gonna get a very similar effect when it comes to run committing. You see, we're shutting everything down in the backfield. So I'll go ahead and I'll do this a couple times just to show you guys how this run defense is shut down. You can see here too, I mean, these outside cornerbacks, they're all the way up to the line of scrimmage. So they're essentially going to, if it's a run, because like I said, this is a glitch that will essentially work. If it's a run play, they will shoot right in. They will take away any outside runs. So I have real no inside lanes. The cornerback's gonna take care of the outside lanes and everybody's just gonna come in and fill. So like I said, easily one of the best run defenses in the game. I mean, there's just nowhere to go. So, you know, if you're playing somebody and they're running the ball like crazy, this is definitely going to stop that. So here we go one more time. Like I said, we got our cornerbacks outside. Nothing's gonna get outside. I'm waiting for an outside run. I'm gonna have to pick that. But it doesn't really matter because they're so far outside of the blockers, they're just going to come back in. This guy, now he's not even getting the time to hand the ball off. So you can see how good of a run defense this is. And we're going to give ourselves a few challenges. So I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to pick that one more time. We're going to go goal line here because that's one of the, you know, obviously somebody gets down to the 1 yard line or something like that. A lot of times they're hitting it with the quarterback sneak. A lot of times they're hitting it with the fullback dive. So we're going to test our defense against both of those. So here we go. One more time. Like I said, the pinch is where it's at. Like I said, that's really what's going to make this happen. And then I'm just going to basically run commit and I'm going to watch these guys work. As you can see, I mean, he's not getting much. He might get that, you know, half a yard he needs. But you can see, this is about as good as it gets. So let's do that one more time. Like I said, we can basically, if you really want to kick up a notch, we can bring this guy right down to the box here. And that's basically, as you can see, he's just getting shedded. Like I said, we're taking away all these gaps. Like I said, if we expect a QB sneak, we can blitz all, and then you're going to want to come down this gap. So this is something that, I mean, no matter where he goes, you can see right there, we actually got a forced fumble, but you can see this is going to be one of the best defenses for goal line situations. So we'll do that again. So we're going to bring this guy down to this gap. If you do this a lot of times, you know, you see that the DT really takes over. I can't imagine he's getting this first down. This is a really good short yards defense. And then same deal with the fullback dive. So we'll pick that. So we'll do it again. We're going to go on the wrong side here. We're not going to even bother. Like I said, we're always going to come in the same gap for the QB sneaking. It doesn't really matter. The fullback's still getting shut down. We'll go ahead and we'll do that one more time. We're going to go random this time on offense. And like I said, we're guessing pass. So, you know, we hard flat. We don't have to hard flat, though. You could always do over the top coverage or whatever. You could leave it as is. The hard flat, I feel like, is one of the better ways to go. And I don't know what happened there. I mean, he looked like he was trying to beat me with a fade or something. But you can see the important part, the real reason I'm doing this is you can see I ran commit and the team did not run commit because it was a pass play. So just keep that in mind. This is something that only works on next gen consoles, but you can see how he did not, the team didn't run commit there even though I ran commit. So we'll go and we'll do that one more time. Like I said, I'm just gonna keep going run commit, hard flats, because this is the full run defense setup. You can see we get that run, and then boom, everybody's just shooting in. I mean, it's just, like I said, lights out run defense. One of the best run defenses. I'm doing this a couple times more just to make sure that everybody sees that if it's a pass play, that the run commit will not take. Because I know a lot of people were doubting that. Here's another run play. Like I said, we're just getting stuffs in the backfield. Nobody will ever run against this defense. So I'm going to end the video there. If you guys want to see more plays out of this, more plays out of defense or more plays out of this particular defense, the Dolphins, hit the like button, let me know in the comment section, or you guys can check out my ebook link in the description below. Other than that, thanks for watching, man. Money shit out.
Need more help or just want to show your support? Then head over to my Patreon and join my team, where you can get exclusive content like ebooks and bonus plays, as well as early access to my bids and more. Link in the description below. Thank you.